Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Monday of the fourth week of Lent. Our Mass Presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. As for me, I trust in the Lord. Let me be glad and rejoice in your mercy, for you have seen my affliction.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who renew the world through mysteries beyond all telling, grant, we pray, that your church may be guided by your eternal design and not be deprived of your help in the present age. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, Lo, I am about to create new heavens and a new earth. The things of the past shall not be remembered or come to mind. Instead, there shall always be rejoicing and happiness in what I create. For I create Jerusalem to be a joy and its people to be a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and exult in my people. No longer shall the sound of weeping be heard there, or the sound of crying. No longer shall there be in it an infant who lives but a few days, or an old man who does not round out his full lifetime. He dies a mere youth who reaches but 100 years, and he who fails of 100 shall be thought accursed. They shall live in the houses they build and eat the fruits of the vineyards they plant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will exalt you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the netherworld. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Sing praise to the Lord, you, his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn, rejoicing.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever will I give you thanks.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Glory and praise to you, O Christ. Seek good and not evil so that you may live, and the Lord will be with you. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time Jesus left for Galilee, for Jesus himself testified that a prophet has no honor in his native place. When he came into Galilee, the Galileans welcomed him, since they had seen all he had done in Jerusalem at the feast, for they themselves have gone to the feast. Then he returned to Cana in Galilee, where he had made the water wine. Now there was a royal official whose son was ill in Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus had arrived in Galilee from Judea, he went to him and asked him to come with him and heal his son, who was near death. Jesus said to him, Unless you people see signs and wonders, you will not believe. The royal official said to him, Sir, come down before my child dies. Jesus said to him, You may go. Your son will live. The man believed what Jesus said to him and left. While the man was on his way back, his slaves met him and told him that the boy would live. He asked them when he began to recover. They told him, The fever left him yesterday about 1 PM. The father realized that just at that time Jesus had said to him, Your son will live. and he and his whole household came to believe. Now this was the second sign Jesus did when he came to Galilee from Judea. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today I'd like to invite you to reflect on the faith, no, or the conversion, if you wish, no, of the royal official, no. First of all, the first point that I'd like to invite you to reflect on as a part of this process of conversion was the humility of the royal official. That's the first point, no. And then the second point was his conversion began by his believing in the word of Christ, no, what Christ told him, no. And then the third point that I invite you to reflect on was that when he underwent that conversion, when he chose to convert, no, he brings along his entire household, no. So first, about the humility of the royal official. Now, very clearly here, the royal official goes to Christ, no, and begs the Lord to go to his house because his son was near death, no. So you realize now that this is a humility born out of love for his son, no. Remember, he was an official, no. He was a royal official. And yet he humbled himself to go to Christ and to beg him to heal his son, no, to come to his house. And so that first point, no, to reflect on, no. Sometimes I think it's good to ask ourselves, where does our humility come from, no? I think when everything is said and done, no, of course, as Saint Teresa of Avila would say, humility is truth, no. It is accepting the truth of our person, of who we are. And here clearly, you know, the royal official, his humility comes from his being the father, no, and his love for his son. So maybe that first point to reflect on, where does our humility come from? Because it is only with a humble heart that we can turn to God and ask. And for me, that's very important, no, because our act of asking or praying or begging is a very deep act of faith, no. So that first point to reflect on, no. And then the second point that I invite to reflect on is that, you know, after the Lord, of course, the Lord said, no, you people always seek signs, no. As the Lord said, he said, unless you people see signs and wonders, you will not believe, no. And then the royal official continues to ask Christ. He said, sir, come down before my child dies, no. And again, the humility, no. And because of that, now Jesus now gives his word. He said, you may go, your son will live. And the royal official, as the gospel tells us, the man believed what Jesus said to him, and then he left. And for me, that's the beginning of the conversion, no, when he believed in the word of Christ, no. And you realize now that this is the beginning, because the complete conversion comes, no, when what the Lord said is fulfilled, no. So maybe that second point for us to ask ourselves, no, do we believe in the word of Christ? Do we believe in what, in our prayer, in our discernment, what we feel God is telling us, no? And I think what is important here, no, as that first moment of faith, is to act on what the Lord tells us, to act on the word of God. Remember, it is to hear and to obey, it is to follow, no? And here clearly the royal official follows, no, acts on what the word of Christ. Go home, your son will live. And no questions asked, he goes home. That second point to reflect on, no? And the third and last point is that because of that, in quotation marks, no, the sign or the proof, no, he completes his conversion. And not only does he complete his conversion, no, but his whole household, no. It says here, and he and his whole household came to believe. So you assume that they were converted, no, to be a follower of Christ, to be a believer in Christ, no. So for me, the third point is also very important, because it is through our own faith and our obedience in faith that will also lead others to conversion. It is the witness of our lives that will also lead others to follow Christ, no. Siguro maganda na pagnilayan natin itong ebanghelyon to, kasi napaka-ano niya, no? Napakagandang halimbawa kung paano ang isang tao ay ano, dumaan sa proseso, no, ng pagbabalik loob sa Diyos, no. Una sa lahat yung masasabi natin, 'di ba, yung kababaang loob, no, ng royal official, no, kababaang loob na pumunta sa Panginoon, ano, at magmakaawa dahil siya nga isang opisyal, no, mataas na tao siya, no. At hindi siya una sinagot ng Panginoon. Sinabi nga ng Panginoon, no, kung hindi kayo makakita ng mga signos, hindi kayo maniniwala. Pero bagaman ganun ang sinagot ng Panginoon sa kanyang unang hiling, anong sinabi niya? Sir, pumunta naman kayo sa bahay. Pumunta kayo sa bahay, di ba? Para pinatuloy niya yung kanyang pagpakiusap sa bahay. At pinalalim niya yung pagkikiusap. Pumunta ho kayo sa bahay bago mamatay ang anak ko. At yun yung kababaang loob, ano? At dito makikita ang simula, ano, ng kanyang pagiging alagad ng Panginoon, yung kanyang conversion, no. Kasi nga sumunod siya. Sabi ng Panginoon sa kanya, umuwi ka na, mabubuhay ang anak mo. At walang tanong-tanong, sumunod. At yan ang unang masasabi natin, katibayan, ano, na nagsisimula na yung ating conversion, no. Dahil nga tayo ay kumikilos, tayo ay sinasagawa natin, ano, yung salita ng Diyos. At yung pangatlo't huling punto ng ating pagninila, ay makikita natin ang pagbabalik loob sa Diyos, no, ang ating pagiging taga, mga alagad ng Panginoon, ay sa ating sariling pagsaksi or pagtistigo, no, sa ating pananampalataya sa Panginoon, tayo rin ay nagiging daan ng biyaya, no, na ang mga tao ay mapiliin din maging alagad ng Panginoon. Siguro ngayong araw, pagnilayan natin ito kasi bahagi yan ng ating misyon. Bahagi yan ng ating pagsasabuhay muli ng krus at muling pagkabuhay ng Panginoon na ating ipagdiriwang sa darating na Semana Santa. Ito ang pinaghahandaan natin ngayong Kwaresma. At wala pang higit pang pagsaksi, no, sa ating pananampalataya sa Panginoon, kundi ang pagsasabuhay at ang pagsaksi natin sa biyaya ng krus at muling pagkabuhay. That in the end, this is the gift of Lent and the gift of a coming Holy Week. For us to renew once more the grace of the cross and resurrection in our lives and renew it in a way that we will witness to it and invite others to undergo the same conversion. So today, let us pray for this. Let us pray that, like the royal official, we may be able to experience, no, that process of continuing conversion. Excuse me. Confident that when we pray with faith to God the Father, He will respond to our request with open-hearted generosity, we now present before Him our needs.
That the Church throughout the world may be a symbol of Christ's healing work by her care for those who are sick in body, mind, and spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That doctors, nurses, and those who care for the sick may show the compassion and gentleness of Jesus in caring for the least of His brethren, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this season of Lent may be a time of healing and reconciliations for families and communities of people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the prayers commended to our prayer or the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And let's also pray especially for the Pope's good health and also for his intentions, most especially for his prayers for peace. And let's also pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May we receive, O Lord, we pray, the effects of this offering dedicated to You, so that we may be cleansed from old earthly ways and be renewed by growth in heavenly life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer our Lenten prayer for the year of prayer.
Father, Son, and Spirit, be with us in a special way in our Lenten journey in this year of prayer. Teach us to pray from the heart and listen to your voice within, telling us to be still and know you are our God. Guide us in our practice of fasting and penance, that it may lead us to greater spiritual freedom and the interior disposition to seek, know, and follow your will alone. May all this inspire us to render greater service to you and to others, and in all things to love and serve you with greater generosity. Let the blessings of prayer, fasting, and penance, and service in this season of grace lead us back to you with hearts contrite and humble, grateful and joyful, hearts burning within us to renew in our life and in our world the grace of your cross and resurrection. Amen.
And let us pray. May your holy gifts, O Lord, we pray, give us life by making us new and by sanctifying us, and lead us to things eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Again, marami pong salamat. And after this, a reminder that papakita ho namin how you can join the Alay Kapa Expanded Program, Fund Campaign. Ano ho ito? Ito yung annual giving. And we request that you join us, no, and commit to give a certain amount. Just commit to an amount that you will give annually. No, you can give it. The ideal is to give monthly, no, so that at least you know what's going on and the partnership is very active. But you can also decide to give it quarterly or twice a year or annually, no. But the real invitation is to help us reach 1 million people by December 2025 who will commit to give us a specific amount every year, tuloy-tuloy po yon, even beyond 2025. So you will see the link and the QR code. And someone will send you the details of how to enroll, how to register to become a partner in the Alay Kapa Expanded Fund Campaign. So that is different from the daily mass collection and donations that you give to Alay Kapa. This one will fund the different dioceses already. We're trying to establish the seven legacy programs in as many dioceses as possible. So marami pong salamat for your continued support, and please join us in this Alay Kapa Expanded Fund Campaign. Maraming salamat po. Have a good day ahead. Have a good week ahead. Thank you.
kawalan ng maayos na kabuhayan. Ito ang mga bagay na nagpapalala ng kahirapan ng mga Pilipino. In 520 communities across the country, 60,000 families na ang ating natulungan. At sa darating na mga taon, palalawakin pa natin ang ating mga proyekto. Kabuhayan na dulot ay marangal na buhay. Ito ang ating Alay Kapwa.